तो जब मैंने वो शॉर्ट स्टोरी फिक्शन में लिखी देन आई फेल्ट ओ दिस इज समथिंग यू नो एंड देन फिर उन्होंने कहा
वाज द लाइट बल्ब मोमेंट
या एब्सोल्युटली कि मतलब मुझे मजा आ रहा है ये करने में.
दिस इज एपिसोड नंबर 47 ऑफ द इंस्पायरिंग टॉक विद स्टोरी टेलर मेहक मिर्जा प्रभु. Welcome guys to The Inspiring Talk. My name is Vijay Gautam. I'm host for this show. Each week I interview today's most successful and inspiring personalities to help you realize your inner potential. I'm super pumped for this one guys. Mehak is an amazing storyteller and writer based in Mumbai. Storytelling through voice modulation is one of her unique strengths. Her storytelling act, Joya Ki Diwali, featuring songs by Mohammad Munim, was listed as top 10 theater acts of 2017 by the Mumbai Theater Guide. I was blown away when I watched her story, Fir Mohabbat Karni Hai, which has gained over 5 million views across digital platforms. Mehak has been featured in Times of India, Dainik Bhaskar, to name a few. She runs an online storytelling school, Jhumri Talaiya, dedicated towards merging classical story form with original stories that reflect recent times. On this episode, Mehak talks about how she overcame challenges such as losing her entire family when she was 19, going through divorce and depression, how to curate stories that leaves audience captivated, her story writing and rehearsal habit. She also demonstrates some voice modulation skills and much more. I enjoyed a lot having this conversation with Mehak. I hope you will as well. Guys, make sure that you share this episode with your friends by visiting theinspiringtalk.com/4747. Now, before I introduce you to Mehak, if this is your first time listening to this show, make sure that you subscribe to The Inspiring Talk podcast on podcast app, which is already installed on your iPhone, or by downloading Google Podcast app on Android so that you won't miss amazing upcoming interviews with successful and inspiring personalities every week. If you have been listening for some time now, you might notice my voice sound a bit different on this interview as I messed with my recording setting. So please bear with that. Now, without further ado, let me welcome the one and only Mehak Mirza Prabhu.
Welcome back, guys. Excited to have Mehak on the show. Mehak, thank you so much for joining me today.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Glad to be here.
So, Mehak, I first came across one of your stories on my Facebook feed a few months back, and I totally enjoyed listening to that story. And it was Fir Mohabbat Karni Hai, which roughly translates to, I want to fall in love again, right? So, and then few weeks back, I again came across your TEDx talk and got to know more about your personal story, and I was moved. And I immediately wanted to have you share your story with my listeners on this podcast. And you are here today, which is very amazing. So thank you so much once again for being on the show.
Thank you, Vijay. This is humbling.
Yeah. And in the past few days, I went back to watch Fir Mohabbat Karni Hai several times. Several times. I mean, number of times. And every single word used on that story is chosen very, very carefully. And I get similar excitement and emotions every single time I watch it. Where does the stories like this comes from?
Like I always say, stories, I don't go finding stories, they come to me. So there are various places where these stories come from. Sometimes just while I'm reading a book or something, a thought just comes and then it stays with me. So whichever thought basically stays with me is what I work on. That's how it happens. If I'm walking on the road and I see something and it stays with me, a story is created. Sometimes I dream of stories. I don't think you will believe me, but at least three of my stories, I've dreamt them. I woke up like 4:30 in the morning and I have grabbed a pen and I have just written down the storyline or a thought that came to me. So yeah, that's how they come to me. I don't go finding them.
So is it basically that you experienced something in your life, or maybe you saw in your life, you know, something that you yourself have lived, or something that other people whom you know have lived? Is it how, you know, you come with these stories?
Not really. I think as a storyteller, of conscious is built by your experiences in life, and that will always kick in while you are creating anything, be it any artist. But I feel that a true artist is the one who opens up to feeling things that they have not even experienced ever in their life. So you are just, you are like an empath at the end of the day. You know, you feel for others. Your imagination can actually imagine feelings of someone you have maybe not even seen, but you can just imagine it. Yeah, that's what I believe.
Yeah, also, and another thing is, maybe, you know, you have gone a lot in your own life and you have lots of stories on your own life. So maybe that is something that's, you know, even if you say it's subconscious level that you get these stories from, I think those experiences that you have went in your own life has helped you a lot in curating the stories like that, right?
See, I would say that the experiences in my life have taught me to open up to anything, to any possibility that kabhi bhi kuch bhi ho sakta hai aapki life mein. वो जो एक चीज है कि ट्विस्ट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ नेचर. द पर्सन हु इज राइटिंग आर स्टोरी, दैट सुप्रीम पावर हु इज राइटिंग आर स्टोरी, क्रिएट्स सच ब्यूटिफुल सरप्राइजेस एंड ट्विस्ट इन आर स्टोरी. आई थिंक ही इज द वन हु इज टीचिंग मी कि स्टोरी टेलिंग कैसे लिखी जा सकती है. आई थिंक दैट इज व्हाट आई लर्न फ्रॉम माय लाइफ एक्सपीरियंसेस. आई डोंट रियली पिक अप इंसिडेंसेस फ्रॉम माय लाइफ टू क्रिएट स्टोरीज, एंड दैट्स द मेन रीजन व्हाई आई हैव गॉन इनटू फिक्शन स्टोरी टेलिंग रादर देन personal storytelling. Except for TED Talk, if you see, none of my stories that are there are my own stories. They are all fiction characters, fictional stories, because I feel there are, in fact, much more things happening around me than what I have faced in my life. And I want to tell those. I want to tell about them.
So before we actually dive into storytelling and getting into nitty-gritty of the story, we want to know your story. So could you share with my listeners about the challenges that you have faced in your life and the lessons that you have learned from them?
Okay. The challenges that I faced at that point of time when things were happening, yes, they did feel a little difficult, and I felt that maybe I don't know whether I'll be able to move ahead. But today when I look back, I feel that he gave me those challenges because he knew that he is going to give me double the strength to handle them. So as challenges, I would say that I'll keep it brief. I was born in a simple Maharashtrian family, and I had an elder brother, my mom, dad. We were a joint family, my chacha, chachi, and my grandfather, grandmother. So ek joint family hum rehte the. And वो एक सेट मेंटालिटी होती है कि बिकॉज आई वॉज अ गुड स्टूडेंट एकेडमिकली, जिसका मतलब होता है कि मैं रट्टा बहुत अच्छा मारती थी तो जो मुझे अभी काम आ रहा है. लोग पूछते आप इतनी लंबी स्टोरीज कैसे याद कर लेते हो, बस और कुछ नहीं, बस हमारे एजुकेशन सिस्टम ने मुझे वो सिखा दिया है रट्टा मारना. सो बेसिकली द जर्नी इज यूजली चॉक्ड, यू नो, अ नॉर्मल बॉम्बे स्टूडेंट. तो मैंने बी कॉम करना था, तो उसके बाद सॉफ्टवेयर प्रोग्रामिंग करनी थी, दैट टाइम इट वाज अ ट्रेंड. उसके बाद एमबीए करना है, सो ये सेट पैटर्न था. एंड देन ऑब्वियसली इधर जॉब और मैरिज, लेट्स सी वाला हिसाब. बट एट द एज ऑफ 19 व्हाट हैपेंड इज आई लॉस्ट माय एंटायर फैमिली इन अ कार एक्सीडेंट. बाय दैट आई मीन इन माय मॉम, डैड, माय एल्डर ब्रदर, माय चाचा चाची, एंड उसके दो दिनों बाद माय ग्रैंडफादर आल्सो पास्ड अवे इन दैट शॉक. सो दैट वाज अ लाइफ टर्निंग इंसिडेंट दैट हैपेंड, एंड जो सेट पैटर्न थी वो सब चेंज हो गई. सो आई हैड टू टेक ओवर माय डैड्स बिजनेस व्हिच वाज गोइंग इनटू बैंकरप्सी आफ्टर हिम. तो वहां से देन आई गॉट मैरिड एट अ वेरी अर्ली एज. देन आई वाज ब्लेस्ड विद अ ब्यूटीफुल डॉटर एट द एज ऑफ 23. बट द मैरिज डिडंट वर्क आउट, एंड एट द एज ऑफ 30 आई गॉट सेपरेटेड, डिवोर्स्ड. देन आई वाज बैक ऑन माय ओन, स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम स्क्रैच. सो लीगल अरेंजमेंट्स ऐसी थी दैट फाइनेंशियली आई वाज नॉट रियली टेकन केयर ऑफ, एंड सो I had to set up my own business. Jo maine kiya, I started corporate gifting, and I was doing very well in it. In fact, ek saal maine wo set up kiya business pura. Mm-hmm. about 1 crore turnover कर लिया उसमें से. I was very 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 happy, frankly speaking. I was feeling like finally free, independent in life, very very empowered जैसे बोलते हैं. But that's the time wherein health took a toll. Somehow the first diagnosed हुआ कि depression है, बाद में पता चला कि it was actually arthritis, rheumatoid arthritis. Or so yeah, it's like if I start talking about each thing, there is a lot within each thing, but that's the basic challenges that I faced. But us wajah se I came into writing, because those months that I was not well, I was at home. For 7 months I was actually homebound, aur jo business shuru kiya tha wo band ho gaya. To उस सात महीन उन सात महीनों में आई थिंक आई वॉज एट माई वीकेस्ट पॉइंट. एंड वेन यू आर एट योर वीकेस्ट पॉइंट, आई थिंक मैक्सिमम वर्ड्स फ्लो आउट ऑफ यू, बिकॉज यू डोंट वांट टू टॉक टू एनीबडी, यू डोंट वांट टू मीट एनीबडी, आपको वो यू आर बाय योरसेल्फ. एंड दैट्स द टाइम वेन आर्ट फ्लोज आउट ऑफ यू, यू नो. सो दैट्स वॉट हैपेंड विथ मी, एंड आई फील ब्लेस्ड टू फॉर दैट फेज टू हैव हैपेंड. अदरवाइज मैं कभी बिजनेस छोड़ के To get into this, सबको डर लगता है. आज भी कोई आके अगर मुझे पूछता है कि मैम मैं फुल टाइम करूं क्या, तो किसी को कहने को इट साउंड्स वेरी रोजी कि या कर लो, पर नहीं, इतना आसान नहीं होता है, मैं समझ सकती हूँ. सो बट आई एम लकी दैट माई सिचुएशन इन लाइफ, द वेरियस सिचुएशन जो हुए वो ऐसे हुए कि आई वॉज काइंड ऑफ पुट इन टू दिस, कि आई हैड टू मेक अ चॉइस ऑफ इधर डूइंग दिस और डूइंग नथिंग. एंड आई चोज टू डू दिस एंड इट वर्कड फॉर मी. सो या I've been blessed. So what I learned is the only lesson, the most important lesson that everybody should actually believe in, that aapko jitne bhi challenges aayenge, strength bhi uske saath aata hai. You have to just believe that it is there with you. That's it.
Yeah, absolutely. So Mehak, what suggestion would you like to give to 19 years old Tejals out there who might be going through the similar situation in their life?
No, just take one day at a time. I know it is very difficult to keep hope during that time. Find people whom you trust. Bahut log honge aapke aas paas, aap akele kabhi nahi honge. That is for sure. For me, I had my mama, mami, who were my strength. I had my friends. Main actually mere friends ke ghar pe 3 mahina rahi thi. Just before my TYB exams. And her family welcomed me with open arms, entire family. मतलब मुझे लगा ही नहीं मैं किसी और के घर में रह रही हूँ. So be open, don't have your ego in place, don't, मतलब you know, वो कभी कभी होता है ना, हम pride लेते हैं हम कि in suffering. Don't take pride in suffering. Yeah. There is no pride in suffering. Find a way out. It's okay to take help. It's okay to feel weak. There is, strength is overrated, I feel. Weakness is underrated. Accept weaknesses. And you will be easy on yourself and you will sail through.
Yeah, I think you made a very strong point there. There is, like, weakness is underrated. Yeah, absolutely. Like, I have always been strong. I have always been celebrated for my, you know, like, strength that I have, you know, to face the difficulties in my life. And how can I be so weak in this situation? How can I ask help? I think that comes into play when you are going through that. And absolutely, please don't do that, listeners. If you are going through that challenge, speak about it and seek help, because it's only going to make you better, right?
Right.
So Mehak, what is so liberating about sharing stories with other people?
I feel more than liberating, it is the connections that you make. The love that you receive back when you tell a story and somebody connects with that story. So, जैसे आपने कहा फिर मोहब्बत नहीं है. Women of the age of 40, 45, they message me and they talk about their own problems. In fact, it's binding. It's more than setting me free. It is binding me to more people, you know. And that bond that is created, that makes me feel inspired to move ahead and do more of this.
Absolutely. So Mehak, do you think you would have ever found this gift of yours if you had not gone through all that you have gone in your life?
See, if it was meant to be, it would have happened any which ways. I believe in maktab. What's written is written. So maybe it would have been different. My stories would have been maybe different. Or वो होता है ना butterfly effect जो बोलते हैं. Have you heard of butterfly effect?
Mm-hmm.
So it's like बोलते हैं कि whatever happens in your life at one point decides what will happen maybe 50 years later. जब बचपन में एक चीज हुई है वो डिसाइड करेगी 50 अगर वो चेंज हो गई तो सब कुछ चेंज हो जाएगा. मे बी इट वुड हैपन इन अ डिफरेंट वे बट अगर ये लिखा था इफ आई वॉज अ मीडियम टू शेयर स्टोरीज इट वुड हैव हैपेंड आई बिलीव.
सो बट स्टिल द पॉइंट दैट आई एम ट्राइंग टू ब्रिंग हियर इज लाइक वी फाइंड द बेस्ट इन अस इन आवर टफेस्ट सिचुएशंस ऑफ आवर लाइफ एज यू सेड व्हेन You know, the God has made a plan to give you challenge, then he has also given you the similar kind of strength to face that challenge, right? So right. Is it also that we feel comfortable with our or on our own zone and not look for what's within us when everything is going well or, you know, the best in us expresses in the challenges situation only?
Yes, that I absolutely agree. We miss out a lot of things when things are going right. We don't want to get out of our comfort zone. And that is something that I in fact tell everybody that if you want to explore something new in life, you have to get out of your comfort zone. Agar aapke zindagi mein challenges aaye nahi bhi hai, aap create karo and you will learn more out of it. Then what you are doing by just sitting and in a relaxed place, in a steady atmosphere, nahi, growth nahi ho paati hai in a steady atmosphere. When you accept the way things are, you will not grow for sure. So I absolutely agree with your point. Challenges do make you strong and do bring out a lot of things that are hidden inside you.
On your TEDx talk, by the way, guys, if you have not watched her TEDx talk, make sure that you do. I will link it up somewhere on the show notes page of this episode. It is very powerful. Mehak shares her entire story on that TEDx talk. So on your talk, you said it is easier for you today to go back to your zero and move in any direction of your choice. What does that exactly mean, going back to your zero and moving in any direction that you want to move?
That means that I'm not scared anymore. That is one thing for sure. I am absolutely not scared anymore of not having anything with me. And that is powerful. I mean, that makes you feel powerful because aap dependent jab nahi hote ho na kisi pe, that is where you will fly. Finally, you will find your wings. So, mera wahi hai ki abhi mujhe dar hi nahi lagta ki jo bhi problem aayega, lagta hai ki ho jayega solve. Ab apna bas kaam karte raho and it is, there are innumerable possibilities. जहाँ लाइफ जा सकती है बिकॉज जो मैंने नहीं सोचा था वो होते रहा है. तो मैं हमेशा ये कहती हूँ कि 30 साल की जिंदगी में इतना कुछ हो गया. आई वॉन्ट टू रियली लिव अ लॉन्ग लॉन्ग लाइफ टू सी कि आगे क्या क्या हो सकता है. सो द जीरो इज एक्साइटिंग. सो जीरो इज एक्साइटिंग.
आई एम ओपन फॉर दिस. यस, ब्रिंग इट ऑन. यस. सो ऑल्सो डू यू थिंक दैट वन हैज टू गो थ्रू चैलेंजेस इन देयर ओन लाइफ टू हैव दिस डीपर or strong sense of confidence in their own life or to get to the level that you are in terms of confidence and in terms of open to challenges, like bring it on. So how does that confidence comes? Is it only through the going through challenges or are there any other ways that people can gain that kind of confidence in their life? Hey, come on, bring it on. What is that kind of shift in the mindset that has to happen to come or, you know, to bring that kind of confidence in yourself in facing challenges in your life?
It's a very individual thing. Like for me, I was a person who was not at all confident. So mere liye shayad ye zaruri tha. I was a person who was very within my family, mera ghar, mera ye, mere friends. I was that kind of a person. So mere liye ye lesson zaruri the shayad. Par koi hote hain jo who are born like that. Who are born empaths, who are born, unke shayad life mein, khud ki life mein na bhi hue ho, lekin phir bhi they feel so much. I know such people who really feel for others in spite of the fact ki unke life mein kuch nahi hua hai. So it is a very individual thing. Har ek insaan jo hai, par agar aap aise ho ki aap closed ho, to zaruri hai ki jab aapke life mein wo challenges aate hai, to aap unhe accept kar lo. Aap koshish karo unme se kuch seekhne ki. But then again, it's an individual thing, a journey.
So you mentioned earlier that, you know, once you have been through all of those challenges and you had to be at your home because you were suffering from depression, and storytelling happened there. You started writing to get your feelings or emotions out on the paper, right? So what happened after that? How you got into the whole entire thing of storytelling after that?
So what happened first I started with is writing. So even today I consider myself a writer first, then a storyteller or a performer. So I started writing and putting my thoughts on paper. So shuruaat ye hai ki woh har ek ka hota hai na, when you start writing a novel likhenge. Theek hai, that is like the first thing ki novel likhni hai. To maine bhi shuruaat ki novel likhni hai, fir pata chala bhai novel likhna is not a cup of tea.
Yeah, I also have 2 pages of Word document typed on my laptop.
वो हर एक का सपना होता है, but hats off to people who I have big, I'm in awe of people who finish their novels. But what I realized is, फिर मैंने of course poetry, because poetry was trending, it still is, you know, कि poetry is something that वो जो बोलते हैं ना कि poetry scene is thriving nowadays. मैंने फिर poetry लिखनी शुरू की English में again. तो वो किया उसके बाद, लेकिन वो सेटिस्फैक्शन जो होता है ना वो नहीं मिल रहा था. लिख तो रही थी लेकिन मज़ा नहीं आ रहा था उतना जितना मुझे कि वो एक बन जाए, एडिक्शन बन जाए. पर फिर मैंने शुरू की स्टोरी, शॉर्ट स्टोरीज लिखना, बिकॉज वन ऑफ माई फ्रेंड ही वॉन्टेड शॉर्ट स्टोरीज टू गो विथ हिज सॉन्ग्स दैट ही वॉज डूइंग. वो होता है ना आजकल की एक ब्लॉग जैसे एक स्टोरी लिख दी फिर सॉन्ग रिलीज कर दिया, दैट वॉज द प्लान. तो जब मैंने वो शॉर्ट स्टोरी फिक्शन में लिखी, then I felt, oh, this is something, you know.
And that was the light bulb moment. Wow, yeah, aha moment.
Absolutely. कि मतलब मुझे मजा आ रहा है ये करने में. और फिर उन्होंने मुझे कहा कि आप एक काम करो, आप मुझे ऑडियो नोट बना के इसका भेजो. आई एम ड्राइविंग राइट नाउ, आई कांट रीड, एक ऑडियो नोट भेजो. और मुझे भी वो आर्थराइट की वजह से टाइपिंग करने में दिक्कत हो रही थी तभी, तो मैंने बोला चलो ठीक है. एंड वेन आई पिक्ड अप द छोटा सा अपने फोन के इसमें मैंने रिकॉर्डिंग शुरू की, एंड आई रियलाइज कि नहीं मुझे लोग मतलब कैरेक्टर्स की आवाज निकाल के रिकॉर्ड करना है इसको. एंड आई एंजॉय डूइंग दैट सो मच. एंड फिर मैंने भेजा और उसके बाद उनका जो रिएक्शन आया, बस दैट डे एंड आज का दिन कुछ नहीं बदला. आज भी उतनी एक्साइटमेंट होती है जब भी मैं एक नई स्टोरी लिखती हूँ, मैं उसी तरह से एक्साइटमेंट में रिकॉर्ड करती हूँ, मैं भेजती हूँ. एंड it's every single story is like me going back to jo main kehti hu, back to my zero, you know. So utni hi excitement hoti hai har nayi story ke sath, and that's what is happening. It's a repeat telecast of that first enlightening moment each and every time I write a story now.
I think the key point that we all can learn from what you just said is not limiting yourself to what you have been doing, since you have been writing poems, but you could have continued doing that even without enjoying that. And I think most of us do same with our life. We continue doing what we don't love just because we have to. But I think the key thing that we can learn is throw yourself into different thing and try out different things and test different thing. And, you know, just find out when you get that aha moment, the moment that, you know, you have been waiting
absolutely
for in your life. All right. This is what I mean.
Thing I would like to add here. The most ignored thing is our gut feeling.
Sure.
ये जो gut feeling जो आती है ना हर चीज के बारे में, जैसे हम exams देने जा रहे हैं, हम nervous हो जाते हैं, where do you feel it? You feel it in your stomach. It's a feeling. It's a very tangible feeling. हर इंसान इसे ignore करता है. जब हम कुछ सही करने जाते हैं हमें gut feeling आती है, जब हम कुछ गलत करने जाते हैं हम gut feeling आती है, हम इसे ignore करते हैं क्योंकि हमें अपने comfort zone से बाहर नहीं जाना. I would request everyone to focus on that gut feeling and follow it. It takes you somewhere.
And see the magic unfolding and see the aha moment and see the excitement. Yeah. Amazing. So, Mehak, you write amazing stories, and each of these stories has their dramatic ends. And you, when we talked about fictional writing, does there always have to be an end with a twist in the story to be effective?
No, not necessarily. Absolutely not. Your story has to be good enough that people reach the end. That's about it. You know, मतलब बस उतना ही है. आपकी स्टोरी टेलिंग ऐसी हो कि लोग आखिर तक सुने. बस, that is the win of a storyteller. अब उसमें अब अगर आपकी स्टोरी में स्कोप है ट्विस्ट लाने का, सो व्हाई नॉट, डोंट वी हैव मूवीज एंड थिंग्स लाइक दैट वेयर इन अ लिटिल टीज टू द ब्रेन ऑफ द लिसनर, बिकॉज द थिंग इज लिसनर्स आर वेरी इंटेलिजेंट. ओके, इफ यू डोंट स्टिम्युलेट देयर थॉट्स, इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू वर्क. एज एन ऑडियंस माई सेल्फ, आई दिस इज वॉट आई लाइक. Okay, I like to be, my mind to be, you know, thrown into a zone wherein all the time I'm thinking ki kya hoga, and last mein I like to be proven wrong. That's what entertains me. So, mujhe jo pasand hai, main aage dal rahi hun. So, be honest. So, you be an audience to your own story. If you enjoy it, that's about it. Aapko aur kuch sochna nahi hai. Another reason is, aap nahi samajh sakoge ki itni sari audience ko kya ek cheez pasand aayegi. Is it possible, Vijay? It's not possible, right? You can only think from your perspective. आप अपने हिसाब से सोचो. आपको अगर मजा आ रहा है, आप उतना ही करो. फिर लोगों को अगर पसंद आया, great. Because if you keep thinking ना, आपकी एक भी स्टोरी बाहर नहीं निकलेगी. लोगों को क्या पसंद आएगा, मैं क्या करूं, मैं टॉपिक कौन सा उठाऊं, मत सोचो इतना. जस्ट डू इट, जस्ट पुट इट आउट एंड देन सी.
एंड आई थिंक वन ऑफ द थिंग्स वेयर योर स्ट्रेंथ्स रियली लाइज is in creating those amazing moments and, you know, connecting dots and revealing something that was totally unexpected on his stories. Even on the Fir Mohabbat Karni Hai, the story ends with that lady chatting with her own husband, and other story on the Amiga phone, and on that story it ends with the you know, son being
spoiler alerts. Vijay is giving out all the endings here.
Okay. What sort of preparation goes behind the scene to create the endings like this, or to create the stories like this? How do you come with those characters? How do you put yourself into the, you know, vocal tone and, you know, modulation of the voice? And how do you actually prepare the entire thing behind the scene?
One is the part which is story writing. एक चीज होती है कि when it comes to storytelling, people need to understand first of all that storytelling is a separate art. It is not telling a story.
This is totally different game. Yeah, writing is one thing and telling is totally different game.
A lot of people, क्या हो जाता है, वो एक script लिखते हैं and then they pick it up and read and they say that is storytelling. या फिर एक novel लेते हैं, उसे पढ़ते हैं and it becomes story. It doesn't work like that. For storytelling, you have to script it differently. क्योंकि जब एक इंसान आपको एक फोन पे अगर कोई वीडियो देख रहा है या अगर नॉवल पढ़ रहा है, ही इज वेरी मच एनग्रॉस्ड इन इट. बट व्हेन ही इज वाचिंग यू टेल अ स्टोरी, डिस्ट्रैक्शंस आर मोर. सो यू हैव टू क्रिएट योर स्क्रिप्ट इन अ वे विच इज ग्रिपिंग, अदरवाइज इट विल नॉट होल्ड द पर्सन अटेंशन. तो वहां आ जाता है द प्ले ऑफ लिटिल वॉइस मॉड्यूलेशंस है या फिर अ लिटिल बॉडी लैंग्वेज है टू कीप द पर्सन एनग्रॉस्ड. Now, when it comes to the twists and everything, like I said, it's the writer in you that kicks in. It's your way of thinking and it's your way of enjoying something that you put it on paper. कि मुझे मजा आ रहा है ऐसे लिखने में तो मैं लिख रही हूँ, और कुछ नहीं है, मैं ज्यादा उसके बारे में सोचती नहीं हूँ. There are stories which are very simple. उसका ना कोई hidden twist होगा ना कुछ होगा, but the it's maybe just a conversation of two people, but sometimes that is so beautiful. Okay? So it has emotions. There have to be emotions. It's not about what you write there. It's about what you make the other make what you make the listener feel. That is more important. So wo hai. And when it comes to voice modulation, I call it voice utilization. जैसे कि अगर अलग अलग आवाज ना हम सबके अंदर है, उसमें कोई बड़ी बात नहीं है. जैसे दादी नानी जब हमें कहानियां सुनाती थी, हु आर माई इंस्पिरेशन, ठीक है, विद व्हाट आई डू, जब वो हमें कहानियां सुनाती थी, वो जब शेर की आवाज निकालती थी, वो अपने आप शेर आया, और जब चूहा बोलती थी, ओ मुझे मत खाओ. अभी दादी और नानी एग्जैक्ट शेर और चूहे की आवाज तो नहीं ना निकालते थे, वो सिर्फ हमारे इमेजिनेशन को एक नज देती थी कि हमारे आंखों के सामने एक डरावना सा ये तैयार हो जाता था और एक मीक सा ये अपने आप तैयार हो जाता था एनिमल, उनके बस आवाज के मॉड्यूलेशन से. जैसे हम भी है, जब हमें गुस्सा आता है तब हम जोर से चिल्ला के बात करते ही है, कितना भी कुछ भी हो जाए हम धीरे बात नहीं कर सकते. और यही अगर कोई बॉयफ्रेंड और गर्लफ्रेंड से बात कर रहा है और मम्मी पास में है तो हम खुसर पुसर करते हैं ना. नाउ दिस इज वॉइस मॉड्यूलेशन. तो मैं अगर एक कैरेक्टर को बड़ी आवाज दे दूं, एक कैरेक्टर को छोटी आवाज दे दूं, तो मैं बस अपना ही जो वॉइस है वो मैं दो कैरेक्टर्स बन जाते हैं उसमें से। तो ये चीजें मैं लोगों को सिखाती हूँ। आई हैव दिस स्कूल कॉल्ड झुमरी तलैया, और यहाँ पे आई इनवाइट राइटर्स टू कम एंड लर्न दिस, हाउ टू यूटिलाइज योर ओन वॉइस टू क्रिएट डिफरेंट कैरेक्टर्स। यू डोंट हैव टू बी अ मिमिक्री आर्टिस्ट, यू डोंट हैव टू बी अ थिएटर आर्टिस्ट फॉर इट। हल्का सा चेंज दे दो, जस्ट नच द ऑडियंस का इमेजिनेशन इन दैट डायरेक्शन, दैट्स इट। बस बाकी लेट देम बी फ्री, दैट इज स्टोरी टेलिंग।
Also, maybe, you know, you derive those kind of inspiration from the character that you are telling or sharing on that story. For instance, if there is some mother out there, then that is inspired by the particular village in particular state. And then you bring out those kind of accents and those kind of voice tones and all that,
yes,
sort of thing.
Absolutely. Another thing is, bahut zyada koshish nahi karni chahiye. लोगों का वर्किंग मेथड कभी कभी गलत हो जाता है। वो ये सोचते हैं कि मैं ऐसा क्या करूं जो लोग जिससे सुन के हिल जाए। दैट शुड नॉट बी अ फोकस, योर फोकस शुड बी वेयर यू कैन डू जस्टिस टू। तो दैट्स व्हाई आई एनकरेज पीपल टू राइट इन देयर ओन रीजनल लैंग्वेजेस। आप अपनी लैंग्वेज में जब लिखोगे ना, यू हैव सीन सो मैनी मदर्स, सो मैनी किड्स, सो मैनी अंकल्स, आंटीज, लेबर वर्कर्स, भाजी वाला, ये वो, आपने अपनी लैंग्वेज में बचपन में इनको देखा हुआ है। तो अगर वो आपको रिक्रिएट करना है ना, वो आपके लिए मुश्किल नहीं होगा, बड़ा आसान होता है। तो स्टिक टू योर रूट्स, गो बैक टू योर रूट्स। लोग बोलते, मैं उनको पूछती हूँ कि विच इज द लैंग्वेज दैट यू थिंक इन, ओके, राइट इन दैट लैंग्वेज। एंड टूडेज यंग पीपल से वी थिंक इन इंग्लिश। सो आई सेड सॉरी, माई क्वेश्चन इज रॉन्ग, ओके, टेल मी विच इज द लैंग्वेज यू फील इन, ओके, राइट इन दैट लैंग्वेज। आपको लग जाती है ना, आप अगर महाराष्ट्रन हो तो आप आईगा ही बोलोगे। अगर आप प्योर लैंग्वेज के हो ना, आप उसी लैंग्वेज का आपका वो निकलेगा मुंह से। सो व्हेन यू फील समथिंग, व्हाट इज द लैंग्वेज दैट फर्स्ट कम्स ऑन योर माउथ, राइट इन दैट लैंग्वेज। और अपनी इंडिया की पॉपुलेशन इतनी है ना, आप कोई भी लैंग्वेज में लिखो, आपको इनफ ऑडियंस मिल जाएगी। तो डोंट गो टू, आजकल उर्दू का फैशन हुआ है तो पीपल वॉन्ट टू से कि मैं हिंदी और उर्दू में, नहीं, मत, जरूरी नहीं है। यू हैव अ साउथ इंडियन एक्सेंट, आई हैव अ स्टूडेंट एंड शी इज डूइंग ब्रिलियंट बिकॉज शी इज क्रिएटिंग साउथ इंडियन कैरेक्टर्स नाउ। पहले वो नहीं चाहती थी कि मैं बाहर आके कुछ बोलूं भी, बिकॉज शी लाइक, आई एम कॉन्शियस अबाउट माई साउथ इंडियन एक्सेंट। आई सेड दैट इज योर, द थिंग दैट यू फील इज योर वीकनेस, इज योर यूनिकनेस, एम्ब्रेस इट। नोबडी एल्स कैन टॉक इन अ कैरेक्टर लाइक अ साउथ इंडियन कैरेक्टर लाइक यू डू। So put that out, and she is beautifully doing it today. So embrace your weaknesses. That's the only thing that will make you stand out.
Yeah, I think that is another very important point out there. Embracing yourself. That not only make a beautiful story, that also makes you, or, you know, builds you.
Absolutely.
Or confidence in you. I was having this conversation with Vidya Vox, the YouTube sensation, and this is one of the things, yeah, that she also mentioned, that, yes, she brings her unique culture of India and she fuses that with English songs, and she creates such a masterpiece of, you know, combination of fusion songs. And I think when you are able to relate, right, or connect with your roots, then amazing things happens. Let's look at the writing and storytelling. Let's dissect that. So first, talking about the writing, story writing part, do you have to get into some zone, or is it that when something comes in your mind, or do you intentionally sit down to write some stories, or you come across some situations and then only you get down to write that story?
The thing is, making this your full-time profession, you have to force yourself to treat it as a job. कि 9 to 5 मुझे बैठ के बस इसी के बारे में करना है। बट कितना भी कह लो, कहानियाँ आती है रात के 2 बजे 3 बजे कभी भी आ जाती है। सो इट्स लाइक, या आई डू ट्राई टू मेक इट लाइक अ डिसिप्लिन ऑफ राइटिंग, ऑफ सिटिंग डाउन एंड थिंकिंग ऑफ स्टोरीज, बिकॉज आजकल प्रोजेक्ट्स आते हैं जिसके ऊपर लिखना होता है एंड ऑल्सो आई डू, बट कहानियाँ अपने हिसाब से कभी भी आ जाती है। यू हैव नो से इन दैट, एब्सोल्यूटली नॉट। लेकिन हाँ, वही जब भी आती है फिर इमिजिएटली लिखनी ही पड़ती है, वो चली जाती है बहुत जल्दी। वो वेरी लॉट ऑफ ईगो स्टोरीज हैव एक्चुअली, आई थिंक दे डोंट, मेमोरी में रहती नहीं है ज्यादा टाइम।
सो डू यू हैव टू राइट और रीराइट एंड अगेन अंटिल यू कम, लाइक व्हेन डू यू एक्चुअली से दिस इज इट, दिस इज द स्टोरी दैट आई वांट टू शेयर, व्हेन डू यू, यू नो, पुट दैट फुल स्टॉप ऑन द स्टोरी दैट यू हैव क्रिएटेड और दैट यू आर राइटिंग?
Yeah, when I listen to my story at least 3 times and I don't find a single place where my gut tells me that ye kuch sahi nahi hai, तब तक मैं उसको सुनती रहती हूँ, तब तक मैं उसको चेंज करती रहती हूँ, एंड ओनली देन आई स्टॉप. दैट्स अबाउट इट. एंड देन द नेक्स्ट लेवल बिकम्स व्हेन योर फर्स्ट परफॉर्मेंस हैपेंस, द ऑडियंस रिएक्शंस टू सर्टेन पार्ट्स टेल्स यू कि यहाँ पे इट्स वर्किंग नॉट वर्किंग, एंड देन यू मेक दो स्लाइट चेंजेस. यस.
And also, one of the things that I also mentioned on the very beginning of this interview itself, that on the story, Fir Mohabbat Karni Hai, I even sent that link to my friend, whom actually I'm coaching with, you know, starting a podcast. And I told him to, you know, he sent me some recording samples and I told him to use the voice modulation and all that sort of things. And I asked him, look at this story. What's this story? Every single word in this story or whatever comes out of Mehak's mouth is something so planned and deliberate. That's not diluting the story. It's just strengthening the story. So how do you pick those words?
Picking, like I said, you know, it's a process of filtering through. So you write your first draft, then you say it out loud and you see where it doesn't work. Another thing you need is a very, some few close friends, or maybe in my case, it's one person, who is your critic, who is a very bad critic for you, you know, who just doesn't boost your ego every time you do something, but actually tells you where you're falling flat on your face. Aise logo ko apne paas rakho. They are the ones who will tell you where you're going wrong, where you're going right, and that will just tighten your final product that you're making. So, you trust few people whom you look up to, and you work with them. It always works that way. So, yeah, it went through a lot of drafts to come to the final thing that you hear. Absolutely.
So that means a lot of hard work goes behind every single story that we...
A lot of fun. You know, a lot of fun.
Yes.
A lot of fun goes.
Yeah, let's put it this way. Yeah. So another thing is, like, when you create those story, then that means you are leaving those characters at least for those moments when you are, you know... imbibing or sharing, or you know, when you are actually delivering those dialogues. So what kind of impact those characters have on your own life or on yourself?
See, eventually you need to realize how to cut off from them. I mean, that character that you mentioned is a very light character, so it has a good effect. You know, you feel after performing that story and all, I feel in fact good. Before getting into that story, however my mood is, however my day has been, even if it has been a bad day, I have to get into a peppy and a romantic mood to be able to do justice to that character, you know. So some characters do you good to perform, but there are some characters, like there is a story called Gudiya, wherein I'm doing a character of a prostitute, a rescued prostitute. So there is a story which is on depression. There was a story which is on child abuse. So those characters really dig in deep inside you and bring the darkest part of you out. But then you don't have a choice. Jitna aap inme ghus rahe ho, unme bhi ghusna padega. So you have to take it with a pinch of salt. And yes, they do affect. You cannot escape that. Wo karenge, aapko effect zarur karenge.
So is it easy or difficult for you to... Now I think after... few years that you have been into storytelling, is it easy for you to move on from the character that you're leaving, or it leaves something within you that stays with you for forever, from every single story with the characters that you build in your stories?
It does. It absolutely does. And I really hope ki main kitne bhi saal main 80 ki ho jaun aur tab tak bhi main jab yahi kar rahi hongi, तभी भी मैं चाहूंगी कि मेरा character मुझ पे impact छोड़े. Because जब तक वो character मुझे impact नहीं करेगा, how will I be able to impact the audience with that character? Because I am a mirror for them into the character. If I am not getting impacted enough, main audience ko wo character kaise dikha sakungi? So main chahungi ki ye characters mujhe disturb karte rahe, mujhe entertain karte rahe, tab tak jab tak main ye kar rahi hun.
Is it learnable skill, the storytelling and story writing?
Absolutely. Absolutely. It is the most basic thing that every human being is born with. Aap mujhe ek baat bataye, jab bachcha nursery mein jata hai, aajkal to aur bhi matlab it has become a thing, ki jab wo jate hai, tab sabse pehli cheez pata hai teachers unko kya bolte hai. Even before they learn to read ABCD or write ABCD, the teacher tells them to do something called as show and tell. शो एंड टेल में क्या होता है, टीचर बोलते हैं कि बेटा गो होम एंड गेट समथिंग दैट इज वेरी योर फेवरेट थिंग, गेट इट एंड शो इट टू द क्लास एंड टेल अबाउट इट. तो बच्चा घर पे जाएगा, अपनी फेवरेट कोई डॉल या कोई टॉय या कुछ लेकर आएगा और अपने क्लास के सामने खड़े रह के उसके बारे में बात करेगा. दैट इज स्टोरी टेलिंग. एंड यू शुड सी ईच एंड एवरी चाइल्ड इज एबल टू डू दैट फ्लुएंटली, इंटरेस्टिंगली एंड विथ सो मच एनर्जी. कोई सिखाता नहीं है उन्हें वो करने के लिए. सो आर स्टोरी टेलिंग स्किल्स आर बाय नेचर अ वेरी प्राइमरी थिंग इनसाइड अस, बस हम भूल जाते हैं. ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम वी बिकम सो कंडीशनड दैट हम भूल जाते हैं कि नेचुरल बात करना है स्टोरी टेलिंग. टू जस्ट टॉक अबाउट समथिंग दैट यू फील कनेक्टेड टू, दैट्स इट. अभी अगर आप फिक्शन स्टोरी टेलिंग करते हैं, जस्ट द प्रैक्टिस इज टू गेट कनेक्टेड टू व्हाट यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, दैट्स द प्रैक्टिस. बट उसके बारे में बात करना तो कोई भी कर सकता है फिर, दैट्स ऑल. सो इट इज एब्सोल्युटली लर्नेबल. ओपन योर सेल्फ अप, बिकम कंपैशनेट टू पीपल, रीड अबाउट थिंग्स दैट आर हैपनिंग अराउंड यू एंड यू विल बी एबल टू टॉक अबाउट इट, फील इट, यू विल बी एबल टू शेयर इट, दैट्स इट.
सो हाउ डू यू प्रैक्टिस दोज स्टोरीज, लाइक व्हाट डज योर प्रैक्टिस स्केड्यूल और maybe have it looks like?
You're talking about my rehearsal schedule. So in the morning, it's half an hour of voice exercises.
What after does that include? Maybe you can...
Voice exercises would be... You have these lot of vocal exercises. Aap YouTube pe bhi jayenge, koi bhi iske upar ja sakta hai. You can search for vocal exercises jisme you open up your throat, your stomach, the head voice. So, because these are the range of voices that we have in our body. So, you know, so agar aap naak se baat karte hai, toh ek character ban jata hai. Agar aap sar se baat karte hai, toh ye dusra character ban jata hai. Yahi agar pet se baat karungi na, toh I will get a nice, sambla hua character. So, yeah, so these are the different range of voices that we have, but you have to rehearse it every single day so that they come quickly whenever you call them.
So, it is your daily practice.
Yeah, it is a, वो तो करना बहुत जरूरी है. You have to take care of your throat. आप खाते क्या है, पीते क्या है. Exercise, physical exercise is extremely important. Extremely important because otherwise you will not have this energy to, and you will not be mentally, you know, excited all the time and happy all the time. वो जो जरूरी हो जाता है to run around and do this thing that you are doing. So physical exercise is another part of the schedule which is important for storytelling and performing. Indirectly sahi. And then rehearsing all my stories, at least 5 stories a day I rehearse. So I give it 1-1.5 hour evening time mein. So yeah, this is, and then baki time jata hai writing mein.
Mehak, you are raising awareness for social causes through your stories. Like the story that you have mentioned, Gudiya.
Right.
Such a powerful story with unmatchable presentation. Why do you think stories have more deeper impact as compared to other form of messages to make general public aware of the certain social issues?
See, according to me, I will not say that, I will not keep a bias, and that would not be fair for me to say that storytelling has more impact than any other this. But a well-crafted message will always have an impact. And storytelling is a powerful tool wherein you can craft a message beautifully. It has to be explored. Usko kam explore kiya jata hai in its natural form. Like a story has been told through various mediums today's time, through ads, through short films, through music videos and all. Topics are getting covered and they are reaching. I'm not saying they are not. But storytelling bhi ek aisa medium hai jo achhe se use kiya ja sakta hai. Because उसमें रिस्ट्रिक्शन नहीं है ऑडियंस को, उसमें ऑडियंस को फ्रीडम है टू इमेजिन इन देयर माइंड. एंड इट इज, इट टेक्स बैक टू अ मेमोरी ऑफ योर चाइल्डहुड व्हेन यू नो योर दादी नानी आपको कहानियां सुना रहे हैं. तो आपको एक सबकॉन्शियस लेवल ऑफ कनेक्शन होता ही है हर एक जन को स्टोरी टेलिंग से. सो यू कैन कैश ऑन दैट, यू कैन रियली कनेक्ट टू पीपल, रीच आउट टू देयर सोल थ्रू स्टोरी टेलिंग. इफ इट इज क्राफ्टेड वेल, इट इज डेफिनेटली अ पावरफुल टूल, दैट्स व्हाट आई से. तो अगर आप वो कर पा रहे हैं, देन व्हाई नॉट एड्रेस सोशल इश्यूज थ्रू इट.
एंड यू डू इट सो ब्यूटीफुली, आई हैव टू यू नो कॉम्प्लीमेंट यू अबाउट दैट.
ट्राई टू, द
गुडिया वाज समथिंग, आई वाज ऑल स्ट्रक लिसनिंग टू दैट स्टोरी. सो लेट्स स्विच अ गियर बिट टू बिजनेस स्टोरी टेलिंग. हाउ स्टोरी टेलिंग कैन हेल्प बिजनेसेस to take their business to the another level.
Business is made by people, right? Now, storytelling will help you become a better person. That's for sure. Because the minute you open up, first of all, as a storyteller, you have to know yourself. वो सबसे मैं जब workshops भी लेती हूँ, मेरा पहला एक घंटा workshop का इसमें जाता है कि एक introduction round करते हैं. अब जब introduction round होता है, उसमें मैं उनको नाम नहीं पूछती, मैं उनके बारे में चीजें पूछती हूँ, things that make them happy, things that make them sad, जिससे वो सबसे ज़्यादा डरते हैं. And by the end of it, I'm giving you my trade secrets here, but by the end of it, I tell them that this introduction was not for me. This introduction for you to say a hi, hello to yourself, to ask yourself, how are you? Because in storytelling, the only thing that is unique is the storyteller. Storyline same hoti hai. Do jan same storylines ke upar cheeze likh sakte hai. Even the style of presenting it, performing it can be similar. But the storyteller is the only unique thing. So, agar aap storyteller banna chahte ho, sabse pehle aapko apne aap ko janna bahut zaruri hai. So, agar ek baar apne aap ko jaan liya, then you will do wonders in the business that you are doing. Because now you are doing it honestly. Now you are doing it not because what is given in the presentation that is in front of you. But you are telling things to people because you believe in them. Aur wo saamne wala, wo pakad leta hai. They react to it. So you will definitely do a bit better business because you will be doing it more honestly, more compassionately.
And also maybe that can help you build the kind of compassion and empathy for the people that yes. are working with you.
Yes. And obviously it helps you become more confident when you do performances of storytelling. So log jab bolte hai ki corporate storytelling karo, you know, aake inko sikhao ki sales kaise bada sakte hai by storytelling. I said nahi, sales storytelling se nahi badhenge. Sales badhenge jab ye storytelling as an art form seekhenge, to unka confidence badhega, unka baat karne ka jo saleeka hai wo better hoga, aur unka thought process uniquely chalega. Those elements are going to help them in creating a better pitch.
So all of your stories are amazing. Which one is your personal favorite?
Personal favorite? Oh, Baba. I mean, it's definitely, it's yeah, like asking which is your favorite baby. they are all extremely dear to me. Extremely dear. But mostly I realize that stories that I have been told to create based on themes that have been given to me, wo thoda sa unko wo stepmotherly treatment mil jata hai. But stories that come to me directly, apne aap khud se jab mere paas chal ke aati hai, unko main thoda zyada pyar karti hu in general.
One dream that you are passionate about achieving today?
I want storytelling to be big. I want storytelling to become something that is at par with theater and Bollywood. Yeah, absolutely.
Do you have any plans to get into Bollywood someday?
मैं हमेशा यही बोलती हूँ लोगों को कि मैं Bollywood में नहीं जाना चाहती, पर मैं चाहती हूँ कि कोई किसी एक्टर को देख के ये बोले, यार तुम एक्टिंग तो बड़ी अच्छी कर लेते हो, आप स्टोरी टेलिंग क्यों नहीं ट्राई कर लेते? You know, like story telling should become a step up rather than a step down.
So these are the two totally different form of arts.
Yes, absolutely. They are interlinked, of course they are interlinked, but they are different. They are still different.
Yes, yes. Is there anything else that we need to know about storytelling, or any message or anything that you'd like to share about storytelling that we haven't discussed yet?
About storytelling, storytelling can become a career. Agar aap usse career-wise dekhna chahoge to, jab tak aap usko hobby rakhoge, wo hobby rahega. पर अगर आप उसको करियर वाइज देखना चाहो, देर आर लॉट ऑफ एवेन्यूज इन इट, बी ए टेकिंग वर्कशॉप्स, बी ए डूइंग शोज, इवेंट्स, बच्चों के लिए आप एक्टिविटीज कर सकते हो. देर इज इन्यूमरेबल एवेन्यूज टू डू इट. सो टेक अप स्टोरी टेलिंग, एक्सप्लोर इट, एंड लेट्स मेक इट एन इंडस्ट्री बाय इटसेल्फ. सो दैट इज समथिंग दैट आई वुड लव टू सी हैपनिंग.
सो मेहक, नाउ इट्स टाइम फॉर द एनलाइटनिंग राउंड. आर यू एक्साइटेड?
Absolutely scared.
Scared.
I'm so bad at these rapid fire things. So good.
Yeah. So you have inspired many people through your life journey and your stories. What inspires you to do everything that you do?
Okay. Now you have asked me two questions here. The first one, I have inspired a lot of people through my life journey. I don't take credit for that at all. Like I say, mujhe challenges bhi usne diye, mujhe strength bhi usne di. I cannot take credit for that. It's what I do from now that I wish to inspire people with. The journey has just started of inspiring. But yes, what inspires me now at this point is when कोई आके मुझे कहता है, सम यंग पर्सन कम्स एंड टेल्स मी कि महक दी, हाँ मुझे आई लाइक पीपल कॉलिंग मी दी, मतलब मैं सबसे बड़ी हूँ इस सर्किट में. तो वो आके मुझे बोलते हैं, महक दी हमने आपको देखा और हमें स्टोरी टेलर बनना है. बस दैट्स अबाउट इट. एंड दैट पुशेस मी कि मुझे ये करते रहना है सो दैट मोर एंड मोर पीपल कैन बिकम, विश टू बिकम स्टोरी टेलर्स, बिकॉज दैट इज एन एंटायर न्यू वर्ल्ड क्रिएटेड राइट देयर विद वन पर्सन.
व्हिच वन डेली हैबिट do you believe has been game changer for you in your success journey?
In my success journey, मैंने एक बड़ी मतलब silly सी बात लगेगी ये, पर मैंने कहीं video देखा था that make your own bed in the morning as soon as you wake up. वो छोटी सी लगती है बात, but actually it changed my entire way things have worked is because you become disciplined in life is what it says. So the discipline that I brought in my life, ki ye time pe ye karna hai, karna hai, karna hai, karna hai, is actually because I feel talent is overrated. It's the hard work and discipline in your life that will take you places. So agar aap wahi cheez karte rahoge, to wo aage badhegi. So this habit of mine, ki karte rehna hai, karte rehna hai, karte rehna hai, and humble rehna hai, down to earth rehna hai, ye cheeze, they are the ones that will take, and I hope to continue like this forever.
So there are book in our lives that comes and leaves us with a very deep impact. Are there any such book in your life that has moved you?
Yes, absolutely. There are, I will say, in fact, 2-3 books, not just one book.
No, Sue, go ahead.
So one book is called Fountainhead. Now Fountainhead inspires me to write. The author, Ayn Rand, she writes so beautifully. The way she crafts the sentence and the philosophy of it, that book inspired me to write. Then there is another book called Sybil. Sybil is a book about multiple personalities. The character in it has 16 personalities. She has a personality disorder. I think that book inspires me to explore different characters. Actually, you know, that book excited me so much with the fact that there are so many characters that today I enjoy making characters. And then there is one more book which is called Many Lives, Many Masters by Brian Weiss. It talks about afterlife. It talks about the spiritual world. And reading that book brought in a lot of peace into me because I lost a lot of loved ones. And reading that book tells me that they are in a safe place. And I believe I am a very spiritual person. More than religion, it's all about spirituality for me. So that book brought in a lot of peace into my life and gave me a signal that one, you are being taken care of. Don't worry, you're not alone. And second, life doesn't end here. There is so much beyond. So work harder to make this beautiful. Sorry, my answer is a little too long for a rapid fire.
No, that's okay. So Mehak, if you have to look back at your life and if there are three things that you think that you could have done differently, what would be those three things?
Three things that I would have done differently? Definitely not. Main itni gustakhi kar hi nahi sakti. Because today, whatever I am, is absolutely because every single moment that happened in my life till now, for me to even think of changing even the slightest bit out of it will be challenging nature. And I am not that, you know, I'm no one to do that. So main wo kahung, because I believe what you utter from your mouth is what you attract. And I don't want to do that. I don't want to mess with the nature. So I'm absolutely happy and I feel blessed with things that they have worked. Till now, I would have loved to have all my loved ones around me, and those things are very natural. Of course they are, but I have no complaints about it. I believe in God's plan. He has made me for a purpose, and I will live for that purpose, whatever, wherever He takes me.
Awesome. So could you share some online tools or app that you use on a regular basis that has helped you maybe in becoming better organized or maybe disciplined or things like that?
Nahi, basic calendar hai. That's about it. And exercising ke liye, wo bhi bata do, exercising app kaun sa sabko use karna chahiye.
Yeah, absolutely.
There's this very amazing app called HasFit, HasFit. And they are so good. Woh aapke saath exercise karte hai, aise lagta hai aapke ghar mein. So nobody has an excuse not to exercise if you have that app. So woh aap le lein aapke life mein. That will really help you. And writing tool wise, book or pen. Bhool gaye na ye sab log ye wala tool. So please, ab woh grammarly, wamerly sab chhodo. Yeah. Pen or book ya pencil or book. Mere paas typewriter bhi hai. In fact, I've been gifted by a typewriter. So I use, go organic. Tools chhodo, organic jao, you will come out with much more honest content, I feel. And that's about it, aur kuch nahi. Aur ek recorder hamesha saath mein rakho, jo you don't miss any of your thoughts, you just keep recording them. Yeah.
Amazing, Mehak. So we have come to an end of this interview, but before that, I have one more question left for you. But before I ask you that question, how can people get in touch with you? Attend your maybe next open mic or maybe learn the art of storytelling by enrolling on your school of storytelling, Zumrit Aliya. So how can basically people get in touch with you?
So I am very active on social media completely because I love connecting to people and talking with them. So bus Mehak Mirza Prabhu, MehakMirzaPrabhu. Ab type kare Instagram pe, YouTube pe, Facebook pe, you will find me. Even on LinkedIn, Twitter, sab jaga you will find me with just this name typed in. And aapko sare updates mil jayenge when my next events are happening. And there is another page called Jhumri Talaiya. So aap mere profile pe jayenge, aapko wahan pe uska samne hi link mil jayega, which is an online as well as offline storytelling paathshala, jahan pe ye sare jo techniques main baat kar rahi thi उसके ऊपर मैं काम करती हूँ, individual basis पे भी and group activities पे भी. And I keep posting the workshop details, shows details, everything on that platform itself and on my Facebook profile. So it's easy to find me, very easy if you want to.
Absolutely, guys. Make sure that you connect with Mehak. And if you have not yet watched any of her stories, make sure that you find her stories on YouTube and go and watch them. You will thank me for recommending, you know, to watch her stories, because she does such an amazing job in telling stories. And actually not telling, I won't say like you are a storyteller, I want to say you are a story performer. I think that would be a right word that that you should be using. You don't tell stories, you perform those stories, you leave those stories. So that is pretty fascinating to see. And also, guys, all the links and resources that we have discussed in this episode, such as books Mehak has mentioned, her social media and her YouTube channel, and everything that we discussed about, and all those videos we talked about in this episode, will be linked up somewhere on the show notes page. Make sure that you visit theinspiringtalk.com/4747. So that's the show notes page of this episode, and you will find all the links to resources that we discussed in this episode. So Mehak, here's the last question for you.
Haji, bring it on.
And yeah, and this is the question that I want you to listen with your eyes closed, and I want to take you on an imagination and answer this question. So imagine that you are standing in front of a stadium, and this one is the largest ever built in the history of the world. Largest stadium ever built, and every single seat in that stadium is occupied, and every single people on that stadium are very eager and are, you know, have their eyes wide open and are listening to you very, very carefully. And you have been given only 1 minute of your time to address these people. What would be your message?
Oh, wow. My message would definitely be, each and every one of you is special. don't be afraid to be what you can be.
Don't be afraid to be what you can be. This is amazing, Mehak. Thank you so much for being on the show. I really enjoyed it.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Bijay. This was absolutely humbling. In fact, the entire session was very, very, very humbling for me. And I hope I have given you, you and the audience who is listening, a little bit of whatever I have lived in my life, something to take away from. And I hope everybody lives a beautiful life.
Absolutely.
Amazingly beautiful life. God bless everyone.
Absolutely. I appreciate that. Thank you.
Thank you, Bijay.
There you have it. TheInspiringTalk.com/4747. I hope you enjoyed this conversation with Mehak. If you got some inspiration or learned something, then make sure to share this with your friends, post it on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram, and let your friends know about this amazing information. Let's share this piece of information and help many others to get inspired from Mehak's journey and insights. You can access show notes page of this episode by visiting theinspiringtalk.com/4747. And finally, as Mehak said, guys, don't try to be someone else. Embrace yourself. Your uniqueness is not your weakness, but your strengths. Celebrate them, and if you are going through a tough phase in your life, please be reminded that you are not alone. Seek help, and this should pass as well. Thank you for listening. I'll catch you in the next. Now, go out there and do something inspiring.